Scott's Geography Notebook.
Did you want to try saying it? Da, da, da.
As we're thinking about the surface of the Earth and changing that surface, there's going to be two major processes that are going on. Those are going to be those endogenic processes and those exogenic processes. So let's take a look at each one of these. This endo actually means inside, right? And the genic is going to be the source. So endogenic processes have their source on the inside, and in this case, it's going to be inside the Earth. So we're going to have some activity, some things that are going to be happening inside the Earth that are going to be the source of change. And then we're also going to have some exogenic. Now, exo is happening outside, and that's going to be a source. So there are going to be things that are happening outside of the Earth that are going to be changing things around. Let's talk first about our endogenic processes. The main source of all of our endogenic process is going to be the radioactive decay. Inside the Earth, there's a lot of atoms that are starting to break down. Because they're starting to break down, it actually makes it very, very hot. As we study the inside of the Earth, as the geologists dig deeper down into the Earth, they find that it is very, very hot down there. Okay, now what does this radioactive decay do? Well, from time to time, it's going to be causing some major movements. Okay. It's going to be causing that energy to forcing its way up. So if we have the surface of the Earth, we have that energy forcing its way back out. Now, that's going to result in a number of different things. The main thing that we start to see are different plates that are going to be shifted apart, because as we force some material into there, those plates start getting moved around. So first off, we're going to see plates. Tectonics. Now, those plate tectonics are going to be causing land masses to crush into each other and all sorts of other things. When those plates start to shift, another feature that we start to see are earthquakes. And the other thing that we start to see really when it gets exciting is when this energy is being forced up through a mountain, and that's going to be causing our volcanoes. Now, each of these guys, our plate tectonics, our earthquakes, our volcanoes, they're all going to be really working on a common goal. They're wanting to build up the landscape. They're wanting to make things bigger. And so we refer to a lot of these processes as mountain building processes. And these mountain building processes have a name. They are called oro for mountain. Genesis, the creation or the beginning. So mountain building processes, the creation of mountain, are orogenesis processes. Good. Okay. So that's going to be causing our landscape to try to go higher, and we're going to be crushing mountains together and trying to make things go big. Well, we also have our exogenic energy, and the exogenic energy is there. The main way that we have our energy from the outside is from the sun. Now, what does the sun do? Well, the sun is going to, in terms of shaping the landscape, it does a few significant things. First off, it's going to be changing or causing differences in temperature. And we've learned before that differences in temperature are going to be leading to differences in pressure. And so those differences in pressure are going to lead us to wind. And those wind processes, that's going to be what is going to be the main thing that is shaping our deserts and our desert environments. Coastal processes as well. So the wind itself is going to be moving material. But also what we're going to see is the wind is going to be causing a lot of ocean wave activity. Right? Both of those are going to be breaking things down. The other thing that the sun is going to be doing is it's going to be causing evaporation. When water evaporates, particularly up off of the ocean, what we're going to start to see is that water falls back down. Right? And that water is going to be falling in the form of rain, evaporation, and condensation. That's going to be the eventual result of this evaporation. It leads to the condensation. Condensation is going to lead to rain. And that rain alone on the surface is going to be causing problems. But we're also going to start to see from that rain rivers and streams and all sorts of erosion and breaking down that can happen from those. The other place that we'll see condensation happening will all be all the way to sublimation, which will be to snow. And that snow, if it accumulates long enough, can form glaciers. Okay, so what is going to be building up the surface is going to be this radioactive decay, which leads to our plate tectonics, our earthquakes, and our volcanoes. All of these are going to be those mountain building or orogenesis processes. When we're looking at our exogenic, endogenic processes, inside endogenic, exogenic, forcing things back down. If we were to look at the surface, all of these are going to be weathering away and trying to make things go down. We might get a difference in temperature, differences in pressure. That looks like cliff. It should say differences in pressure, which will lead to wind. And that wind is going to move material itself and erode things away. It's also going to be causing the waves on the ocean. It's also going to be causing evaporation. That eventually is going to be leading to condensation. And so we're going to be getting rain itself landing on the surface, and rivers are going to be coming down, and glaciers are going to be coming down, and all of those are trying to smooth the surface of the earth back out. It's a balancing act between those endogenic processes trying to build things up and the exogenic processes trying to build things back down.